Hey, greetings, friends, and welcome back to Alloy 7's complete playthrough of Star Ocean 5, Integrity and Faithlessness, or Faithfulness, depending on how you do your search on YouTube. I'm your host, BC, the Brain Supreme here. Very happy to be bringing you this complete playthrough again, trying to figure out, is Star Ocean 5 worth your time? Does Star Ocean 5 have the stuff to become my favorite Japanese role-playing game of all time, considering that Star Ocean 2 currently holds that title? Tonight, we're focused on the combat system. It's all about the combat tonight. Tomorrow night, or tomorrow on the next show, rather, because a bunch of these will probably come out daily. On the next show, I'll be showcasing how open or closed the world is, which has been a point of contention for a lot of people playing the game. But today, on today's show, we're going to be focusing on treasure chests that we can't open, unfortunately. Got to find a way to get that open. Strangely enough, Matoi Sakuraba, good lord, if I could speak tonight, reprised his role as the composer for this game. And as you can tell, if you're familiar with Star Ocean 3, this is the music from Star Ocean 3. But let's get into some combat here. I didn't pull it off. I was trying to get a preemptive attack by hitting attack quickly enough. So here's how we're going to play this. R1 and R2, right? Or excuse me. R1 and L1 allow me to pick my targets. I do it manually. You can set it up to work. You can set it up to work auto. I like to do it manually. And then you come in. That was a power attack that he did there. When he lights up blue, you want to use your short range attack or your weak attack to knock him out of it. And then you want to block here when they get up close. And then get down to business. Now, you don't want to... The way I'm doing these special moves is by holding the button down to pull them off. But you'll notice that you pause for a second in order to be able to pull those moves off. And she's going to do some healing, which is good. Let's get this treasure chest here. Got some mint. Let's actually go into the menu and look at. So we've got roles, right? So we can set roles. Right now I'm an attacker. Of course, Miki is a healer. I could switch her to becoming an attacker if I wanted to. I can switch our buddy Fidel here to being a healer if I wanted him to. All right, we're going to go through the progression of how we level these things in a later show. But I just want to show you that these are the skills from which I'm pulling. So if I look at my set battle skills right now, I've got double slash. That's my short range attack, or rather my weaker attack. And then I've got double slash, which is my stronger attack. And if I hold them down, it uses 4 and 5 MP respectively. And then here, my long range attacks are exactly the same attacks because right now I have nothing else in my inventory in order to put in its place. Right now, my strong and weak attack are the very same attack until I learn something new. Same with Miki here with the firebolt. Pardon me. And that's what we're using in battle. Very simple. Like I said, tonight's or today's episode, depending on when you may be watching, is focused just on the basics of combat. So we've got animals fighting each other. Once again, I mess up the part where I'm trying to get preemptive attacks. We'll get it right here eventually. I want to be careful not to use up too much of my MP, but if I'm guarding during regular attacks, trying to get him to attack me, get in there. Got him. Now, one of the things I have to get used to, because I'm a little bit further into the game in my, you know, my playthrough, I have to get used to being weak again. I'm much stronger right now than I am on this particular playthrough. So you can see I'm picking up shellfish meat and raw fish. Going to come in handy with the cooking and crafting that we'll get to do later. Don't have that skill as yet. One thing I forgot to show you is the specialties menu. Right now we can focus on harvesting. I do have enough. So you see the crystals there in the bottom left hand corner of the harvesting skill. I hit the button. I've got enough of those crystals. If you look up at the top, kind of right hand center, I've got 57 to the 25 that's required. I hit yes. And now yours truly is able to harvest on the map. The beautiful thing is now the harvesting points show up on the map. And I can run to them. I'm going to do that now and show it to you. Here's one of the most beautiful things. And this is something we'll cover in more detail on the shows about customization and leveling. Did you notice I got 3 SP just from harvesting? So now I'm incentivized to explore the world. Why? Because doing so not only gives me more material, but it gives me the currency I need to get better at the game, to get better at combat, to get better at whatever the case may be. That is something that's really reminiscent to me of, and see, you even get experience points for harvesting. So she just leveled up, which is dope. And that's a That takes me back to Mass Effect 1. For whatever reason, none of the other Mass Effects actually did that. That was disappointing because it was one of the things I loved about Mass Effect to no end, was that basically everything I did in the game contributed to me leveling up. Now, that says nothing of the fact that the leveling system was basically completely scripted, thus rendering leveling completely unnecessary, but that's BioWare games for you. That's why I don't play them anymore, because they don't let me do my favorite thing, which is leveling up. So one thing I did forget to test, and I want to do it on this show because I think it's important, and I think it's a question that many of you will have, even though it's not directly related to combat, is does going to the save point, we're going to skip these guys here, if I can get away from them. Yes, I can. Excellent. What I want to know is, does going to the save point restore my HP and MP? That's the question at hand. I really hope that it does. One of the things I was disappointed with in Star Ocean 5 was that it just doesn't have save anywhere, which has become kind of a staple of role-playing games. So no, going to the save point actually does not restore your juice, man. That is old school, to say the least. I don't know if I'm happy about that at all. That means I'm going to have to consume items, something I hate doing. I only like to use items in boss fights. I don't like to have... Ah, there's my preemptive attack. Excellent. Got them, and they're down. Didn't even give her time to pull off her move, which is fine by me. So, and then you can come to the menu here, look at your status. You can actually see what, like, I'm a level 4, she's a level 4. I love the artwork in this game. Really, really dope. And I'm glad they kept it artwork in the US. My concern when I saw what the Japanese were doing was, oh, they're totally gonna westernize that when it comes east, or it comes west. They're going to make it all Mass Effect-y and ridiculous. And they didn't. They kept kind of true to form. There we go. Another preemptive attack by yours truly. Now, hopefully, I won't have to do any blocking. Again, just basic combat. All I'm doing right now, essentially, I should have blocked right there, but I didn't. Because I'm just mashing the X button and the circle button, which is doing my more powerful attacks. There you have it. Getting more shellfish meat by the day. But again, this is the basics of combat, what I wanted to show you tonight, or today, once again. So combat is one of the things I needed to mention up front. Good God, I hope you stuck around long enough for me to say this, because it's important. A lot of questions about, since this game is kind of hailing back to Star Ocean 3, you know, a lot of people were annoyed by Star Ocean 3. I was one of them. It's my least favorite Star Ocean. In fact, I don't even know if I'd say I like Star Ocean 3. It did a lot of stupid things, like killing you when you ran out of magic points, which I think is idiotic. Because, of course, there's monsters in the game whose main attack drains your MP. Go figure. And the blocking and countering system was very tedious. Very clunky. The blocking and countering system is similar in this, but it's removed the tedium. It's streamlined it. It's made it easier, which is a godsend and a blessing, to say the least. All right, I need to block. I'm going way too hard in the paint right now. So just know, in terms of, you know, for those of us who were annoyed by Star Ocean 3's combat, do we have anything to worry about? No. It's definitely well improved over Star Ocean 3. Is it better than Star Ocean 4? Thus far, I can tell you it's not as complicated. Like, Star Ocean 4 had a lot of moving pieces. Also, Star Ocean 3 had that meter that you raised up. Star Ocean 4 had it too. This one doesn't have that so far. I don't know if it'll introduce it later. I'm sure those of you who've been watching other playthroughs may have that answer. And now level 5. Excelente. I want this harvesting piece here. Let's get these dudes taken care of. And what I'm hoping I can do is basically just juggle this guy so that he can't attack me. But his buddy's going to throw poison. And of course, I couldn't see it. There you go, girl. All right, good work. Good teamwork. It wasn't even worth the effort. All right, I didn't even look at what I just harvested, which is probably problematic. All right, that's going to the end. I want to run down here to the beach real quick, do some more fighting, and make sure I've harvested everything that I'm supposed to. Ah, there we go. Fresh sage definitely comes in handy. I actually had to use it in the first, you're going to see I think we'll take this all the way to the first mini boss fight, or boss fight if you want to call it that. I'm not going to fight respawns right now. One thing I will do is heal before I go into that boss fight, because I got Miki killed. And we don't want to do that. We don't want Miki to die, man. We want Miki to be alive and well. We want her to helping us, very much helping. We want the treasures of the world. All right, let's do it. Ah, preemptive, got him. Block, block. There, now my block was on time. Ah, didn't get the block off in time. Riki could sure use some of your magic, sweetheart, if you're not busy. Ah, he did that stupid area of effect spell, which was smart on his part. Oh, that's why Miki's not using her spells. Forgive me. My microphone is in my way. I just realized why Miki's not helping me. She has no MP left. Now she does. So we'll get into, let's see, configuring. So Miki, supposed to be a healer. I don't know why that turned off. All right. Because what I want to do, I want to set disposition, but it doesn't seem like that's a thing that this game allows. Yeah, it doesn't seem like it allows you to set disposition, but the cool part is you can also upgrade these skills, right? So I'm sitting here hitting the upgrade the skill button. I don't know why it's going to level one. Oh, okay. I'm hitting the wrong button. All right, so I'm looking for, you know what, we'll get into that when we get into the character customization. I'll get some more time to play around with that so I can actually speak on it intelligently, succinctly, and concisely. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got another crab catcher. And a preemptive strike. Block, block, fool. So I do like that you can block on the move. You don't have to stay stationary. There we go. Hit him one more. There it is. Game time. Really need to get more, not used to using my special moves, but I need to get in the habit of using them a little bit more. I have a tendency to be a conservator when I play these games, not use my skills, try to get by with what I have, not spend a lot of money. In this game, it's almost necessary, at least in the early stages, until you get a little bit stronger, which I could, like, if I were playing this and not filming, I would totally just power level here for a couple hours so that I could decimate everybody with a couple hits, if not one hit. Got him, and he's done. Ooh, I've dealt 99,000. Wow, I've done 99,999 damage already. Ah, this is where this treasure chest was. I totally missed that. Let's give her the arcane. Oh no, I didn't miss that. I did get that on the live stream. Let's go ahead and get her the arcane bracelet. Max MP goes up +3, and let's use another blackberry on her. We got plenty. She needs it. Let's go ahead and max her up. Might as well use some on me as well, because I'm going to need it in the fights. Hopefully we'll learn a skill where we actually regenerate those abilities. Alright, here come the rhino tree guys. Alright, they saw us before I could pull off the attack there. Ah, that was a power attack. I can't block that. I got to knock him out of it. Ah, I need a move that lets me run out of the way. Come on, strike, fool. Oh, he's blocking. All right, let's get it in. The good thing about these guys is they're incredibly slow and nowhere near as, you know, strong as they look. Now you can basically beat them down very quickly. Good, I knocked him out of his power move. I didn't think I was going to actually pull that off. Nice. Level up, level 6, y'all. I love the fact that you level up so quickly in this game. So if you're not aware, leveling up and getting stronger is my favorite thing to do in RPGs, because I love to power level and then decimate everything that I face. It's kind of my thing, man. Kind of what I do. So when RPGs like Mass Effect don't allow me to do that, I get a little perturbed, if you know what I mean. Thankfully, most Japanese role-playing games don't have that problem. Thankfully, also, you cannot jump off the cliff here, in case you were wondering. My son always asks me that. Yo, Dad, can you jump in the water? I'm like, what? Why do you care? Like, Why would you jump in the water? I mean, I guess if I could, I would, but, you know, and maybe it's because I've played hundreds of these types of games and I know better. I know there's nothing in the water. Or if it's like, you know, a Risen game, the water kills you if you swim in it because, you know, he can't swim even though he's a great adventurer. That's the one skill he missed during training. Oh, they went hard in the paint right off the top. So if you're not aware, the battle music and the map, the world map music, are the exact same songs, just doctored up a little bit from Star Ocean 3. So Mr. Matoi Sakuraba reprised not only his role, he reprised his music. So this game takes a lot of that game's music. I'm hoping, though, that it gets some of its better music. I was never a big fan of the world music on this game. I mean, it's not bad. His soundtracks are some of my favorite of all time. So it's good music. It's just these particular songs are not my favorites, if that makes sense. It's over already, my sweet. Worry not, my lady. Worry not. All right, I check every nook and cranny. Some of you are going to have to. That's the other thing. So, like, if I had to pick two of my categories for my review system that describe me best, it's builder, which is a person who likes to power level, and explorer. And exploring usually has something to do with my building obsession. So just bear that in mind. You're watching me play. I'm running around the corners to check for treasure chests. Let's save up here just in case we get served. Yes, I want to overwrite, if that's okay with you, PlayStation, with your long save sequence menus. All right, here come these dudes. Remember these guys from, I think, Star Ocean 3 and 4? I know they're in 4, but I think they're in 3, too. Got him. It was not even worth the effort. Okay, let's make sure there's a harvest point up there that we can't get to just yet. Let's check around this corner, though. I think we can get this treasure chest. I think that's something that we're going to want to do. Yes, sir. Aqua berries, indeed. So one of the things we're going to talk about on the next show is the map. And the fact that a lot of people have complained. Block, block. Ah, it takes too long to block. A lot of folks have complained about, you know, how constrained the maps are. And apparently the further you get into the game, the more the maps repeat. I'm not a big... I prefer open world Witcher 3, two worlds type games. Don't get me wrong. I like a big open world. But I don't necessarily know that Star Ocean needs all that. Because it's a much more concise game. It's definitely more focused on Star... Oh, here's how you get to the harvest point. Imagine that. I got some green fruit. That's going to come in handy. Oh, yeah, girl. I'm ready now. Come on, dust them off. Dust them off. There he is. There they go. Not even ready. Hit him with the power attacks. Hit him with the power attacks. There you go. Let's see what else we can harvest. I remember Star Ocean 4 just harvesting to my little heart's content. Like, I was a harvesting fiend. I think the harvest points respawn after a certain amount of time. I think that's a thing. So, the map connects in two places here. It's kind of what I'm showcasing for you. We're going to go... The way I went to the boss fight the first time was the other direction, but we're still going to be able to get to it by going this way. I can't really use a pointer on the screen, but if you look at where I'm at, that fork in the road, I went the top route. But going the bottom route is going to get us the same way. Plus, I don't think I got this treasure chest when I did that the way I did it before, which works in my favor. All right, let's get the fish. Come on, hit him. See, the special move is beautiful because it hits multiple enemies at a time, which is delicious. There you go, girl. There you go. Dust him, dust him, dust him. One more hit. Got him. I love the fact that they have a life bar, too, that shows you how much life they have left. Not just the numbers on the screen showing you how much of a beatdown you're giving them, but it actually shows you, yo, this dude has not got much longer to live because of the beatdown you're giving him. Definitely a fan of that addition to the combat system, or at least to the user interface, or the UI as we call it in the business. All right, let's get down to it. Let's get down to it, sons. Dust them all. There we go. Want them on the ground. Now, the other one should be distracted by Miki. He's not. Now, he's just blah. Ah! He's too fast. Make sure I keep an eye on Miki's magic. There you go, girl. Perfect double team there. Ugh. Dust it. I want my harvest point. I think there's going to be a skill that also shows you the treasure chests on the map at some point. Iron 2. It says there's a harvest point right here. Ah, there it is. It's blended in with the word. We are blending like wine and babuti. We are blending. Your boy has no skills. Schooled by a little girl. All right. If anybody knows the songs that I'm singing, 10 points. Because those are not BC originals, believe me. Oh, snap. Is the monster here? We need to make sure we don't get serviced. And if he's showing up, we need to make sure these dudes are dead before he does. Okay, so no, it just appears that she hears the monster before he actually shows up on screen. Now, yes, I definitely want to give Miki, not equipment, I want to give her some more blackberry action. I think I'll be all right with one. Health is good. I think we can roll with how much health we have. Hopefully I'm not... better safe than sorry, because Miki got serviced last time. I'll be all right.
That thing's huge. How are we supposed to beat a mountain?
Pardon me. Little head cold here. All right, dust. All right, I know it's coming. Right now, focus on getting his minions out of the way. Oh! Please help. Miki, little help here, sweetheart. All right, now this is how I got her served last time. I focused on the little ones, and then she went hard in the paint after this dude. All right, I got here faster this time. Now, we're supposed to be enlisting some help here. Miki, heal, girl. There he is. Allow me to help. By all means, help. Do all the helping you want to do, brother. So I go straight hard in the paint as the attacker here. Now Victor, that's the guy's name you're going to learn here in a second, is our defender. So he will absorb some of the beating if you let him. Ah, I got to let him though, that's the problem. This thing is bent on getting after me. Ah! All right, Miki, there you go, girl. Nicely done. Bossfights.com, yo. All right, keeping an eye on health. We're good. Game time, baby. Boss fight in the books.
We can't thank you enough for that.
Long as you're safe. My name is Victor Oakville. I'm a soldier with the Rasulian army.
This is Miki Savister.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Fidel Camuse. I teach swordsmanship in the village of Stahl.
Camuse? I knew it. Those techniques had to be the same as Daryl's.
They certainly are. Although, if I had to guess, I'd say your style has also been influenced by him. Did you study under him in the army?
Of course I did. How interesting. I never knew my master had a child. It's dangerous around here. Let me escort you to the next town.
As representative,
yeah, escort us, brother.
We're on our way to ask the king for reinforcements. As for why we're doing that, it's because Adelon recently tried to invade our village. I hate to sound presumptuous, but do you think you could take us to the person in charge of dispatching troops?
We share both experience on the battlefield and a relation to the same individual. I'll take you to the capital, but I can't assure you of the outcome.
Thank you so very much. Do you think the crown will help us?
The timing is far from perfect, but if Mr. Camuse were to put in a good word...
What about old man Camuse?
Master Camuse currently works in the capital as an advisor for Rasulia's military, where he teaches the way of the sword. Within the army, his word is law.
The old man's really that important now?
He is. That is but one reason it would behoove you not to call him an old man in public. Save that for us.
I guess that makes sense. I'll work on it.
You'll work on it. Ladies and gentlemen, Miki's going to work on it. Next stop, the capital city with Victor as our escort. Now, you definitely want to tune in for the next show because I'm going to showcase where the world map actually opens up a bit. Everything you've seen so far has been kind of constrained, which was on purpose to build up to the point that not all of the maps are quite this tight. All right, some of them actually do open up, like the one you're going to see next in the area that we're going to. So be sure to subscribe to the channel here if you have not already. Be sure to tune in for the next episode, which should already be uploaded by the time you're watching this. And be sure to check out Let's Play StarOcean5.com. Get on the mailing list so you know when we're streaming live, so you can be eligible for the giveaways that we have, giving away keys, so you can get your own free copy of Star Ocean 5, compliments of my good friends at Square Enix. Until next time, friends, until all are one. I'm BC. You've been watching Alloy 7. Thank you so much. I love you guys, and I'll see you on the next one.